In this video, I'm going to show you how to change your location in Google Ads. I'm going to show you how you can stop getting leads and clicks from the wrong locations. Like you're targeting one location, but you keep on getting clicks and calls from a completely different location that you didn't target. And last but not least, I'm going to show you what to do if you have multiple branches. Like for example, if you have a branch in New York and one in another area of New York, but you don't want the customers that are going to the one branch in New York to go to the other branch. Is that confusing? I feel like that's confusing, but we'll leave it in the video and I'll show you exactly how to change your location first. All right, so I'm in my Google Ads dashboard over here and you can see that Google doesn't make it easy for us to understand exactly where to change our location. So the first thing I want you to do is come over to campaigns and make sure you have the specific campaign selected that you want to change the location for. Now there's two ways to do this. The first way is you can go to campaign settings. Once you do, you will see something over there that says locations. And then what you can do is go over to advanced locations and you can just easily type in your location and you can basically just click on include and that will basically include that location and then you can just exclude the other locations or you can just take them off the list. So that's the first way to do it. Another way that you can do it is you can go over to your main campaign window and you can go down to audiences, keywords, and content. I know it doesn't say locations over there for some reason, but what you want to do is you want to click on locations. Now, when I do that, you'll see all of the locations that I'm targeting right now. And what you want to do is click on this little blue pen or little blue circle with a pen on it, and then you'll see all of your targeted locations. And all you need to do at this stage is you can just type in the location you want to target and you can click on include over there. And basically what it'll do is it'll include that specific location in your targeting. So that's basically how you can change your location. All right, so now we know how to change our locations. Now, how do we make sure that we're not getting clicks and calls from locations that we don't want? What you need to do is basically go over to your campaign settings. Once you do that, you're gonna go over to locations. Now, you'll notice it says locations USA, and it also shows excluded locations. In fact, that says Arizona, USA. Let's just get rid of that because that's just confusing. So as you can see, I'm targeting the USA. But here's the problem. Usually when you're targeting an area, you'll notice you're getting clicks and calls from outside of that area. And that's because Google has carefully worded this next section to kind of confuse you and make you choose the default setting. So what you want to do is you want to click on location options. Now notice it says presence or interest, people in, regularly in, or who've shown interest in a location. Now, if somebody has shown interest in the USA, maybe they're from Canada, maybe they're from Mexico, you can be in a different location and show interest in another location. We don't want that. We want people specifically in the USA. So here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the second option that says people in or regularly in your included locations. And what that's going to do is it's going to block Google off from trying to show your ads in different areas that you didn't target in the first place. So that's very important. That's the first thing you need to do. And I'm just going to hit save over here. The second thing that you want to do is you want to go back to your main location over here, or rather your main campaign view over here. You want to go to the location side. And once you do that, you want to make sure that all of the areas around your target area, you want to exclude those. So how do you do that? All you need to do is come up here to location exclusions. Now I'm going to use USA as an example here, but obviously you're probably going to be doing this on a city level or state level. It's just this way, it's very easy for me to just explain to you. So if you are at a state level, you would just exclude all of the states around your state just to make double sure that Google doesn't show their ads there. So over here, because I'm targeting the entire USA, what I'm going to do is I'm going to type in Canada. And I'm going to make sure that I exclude Canada. And you'll see there's this little red overlay that appears on my map. And what I'm also going to do is I'm going to make sure that I exclude Mexico. Just give me a second. Let's do that. I'm going to make sure I exclude them. So now there's absolutely no way that my ad is going to show outside of where it's supposed to show. And all I need to do now is click on save. And that's it. That's how you exclude locations, and that's how you stop those clicks and calls that are from people who are not in your location coming to your location. All right, so what do you do if you have two or three or four branches and you don't want ads for one branch to show for the other branch? Now, I've got an example here where I have a branch in Cape Town and I also have another branch of my company in Stellenbosch. And you'll notice these little circles around them. That's basically their advertising radius. Now, if you're wondering how I did this, all you need to do is go to locations. You can add a location over here. I'm going to say radius. I'm going to say I want a 10-mile radius around my one branch, and you can put in the physical address or you can just select the city, which I did over here. So I've got Cape Town over here, but we've also got Stellenbosch that's right next to it. Now, what I recommend you do in this situation is first separate out your locations for each branch into a different ad campaign. Once you do that, what you want to do is you want to include one branch and then you want to exclude the area around that branch. So I'm going to show you exactly what I'm going to do in this situation. Let's say this campaign is for Cape Town. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to take Stellenbosch off. I'm going to say save. And then, by the way, if you haven't been to Stellenbosch, go. They've got beautiful winelands. There's a university over there. It's a really cool place. Make sure you add it to your bucket list if you haven't gone there already. So I've got Cape Town over here. And then in my excluded locations, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add Stellenbosch, right? And when I do that, you'll notice that Stellenbosch is not going to show. So my ads are not going to show in Stellenbosch. And then I'm going to say save. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the other Cape campaign that I'm running. So let's just go over here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to exclude Cape Town. So I'm going to go to Cape Town. And I'm going to make sure that that's excluded. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to include Stellenbosch. So I'm going to just go here. I'm going to say radius. I'm going to say 10 miles. Come on. There we go. And I'm just going to type in Stellenbosch. And I'm going to say include. And I'm going to say save. Just hold on. Give me 1 second. I don't think I pushed save for Cape Town. Sorry about that. I'm going to say Cape Town over here. I'm going to say exclude. And I'm going to say save. Right? So what you're going to notice here is you're going to notice that Cape Town is in red, which means your ads are not going to show. But Stellenbosch is definitely going to show. Now, you might be wondering, Devin, but these circles are kind of overlapping. And this is where it gets a little bit tricky. What you want to do is you want to play around with your radius and you want to make sure that you're targeting that exact area, because sometimes when there's an exclusion and an inclusion, Google is not going to know which one is going to take priority. So try and map it out a little bit more carefully, maybe go to the suburbs around that circle. But that's basically what you want to do. And that way, you know the ad you're running is giving traffic to the correct branch. Now, if you enjoyed this video, you'll want to check out my Google Ads community. It's specifically for entrepreneurs who've been burnt by agencies and are fed up and they want to run their own ads, but they want to do it confidently and independently. I'm going to give you all the tools you need to run winning campaigns with Google Ads. I'm also going to go in that community and I'm going to be live every single week so you can ask me any burning questions that you have about your ad campaigns until you learn to master Google Ads for yourself. There's also a 90-day guarantee, which means if you don't improve your Google Ads results in 90 days, your next month in the community is completely free. So you've got absolutely nothing to lose. What I'll do is I'll link it below in the description. And if you're a solopreneur and you're sick and tired of agencies and you just want to figure out this Google Ads stuff for yourself, then this is the perfect place for you to be. Lastly, thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate it. It was a short one this week, but I had so many people ask me this question that I figured I'd just put it into a video. Let me know what you're struggling with down below and I'll do my best to help you. And also, you can check out this video next if you want to learn Google Ads. See you next time. Peace.